Escape room workers of Reddit. What's the most absurd thing players have done? Not sure if this counts. I did an escape room with a group of friends. At the end, you found a flash drive which was supposed to be plugged into a computer. We opened the document and there were instructions to print. We got print, and the printer gave us an out of ink error. We assumed this was part of the game, and started looking for a magenta cartridge. Then an employee slipped in the room, replaced the cartridge, and told us to hit print again. Apparently it was not part of the game. They just ran out of ink. A group came in that disassembled some of the furniture, a bed and a desk, ripped some of the wallpaper off the walls, and pulled the heads off some stuffed animals. I don't work at one, but my coworker went to one last year and his story was hilarious. He's a really serious guy from Boston, got talked into going to one with his wife and a few old friends that had come down for vacation. He said as soon as they walked in he saw a broom that looked completely out of place, so he grabbed it. He thought they'd need it at some point. They made it out of the first room. They go to the second room, and he still got the broom. He swears it was just too out of place to not be part of the puzzle at some point. They make it through the second room. The third room, they get stuck. They're reading the clues over and over, and he gets fixated on the broom, while everyone else is searching the room. He's looking it over up and down, checking the handle for markings, mind you he has terrible nearsight vision, and checking the bristles. Time's running out, and he's arguing with his wife at this point, that the broom has the final clue. Time runs up, they walk out, and the crew is just dying laughing at him. Someone left the broom by mistake, nothing more, nothing less. He carried that damn broom through three rooms. He got a good laugh about it later, but he was embarrassed at the time. It was a great story he told the next morning at work. I work at an escape room and too many customers come to play and then put the torches in their mouth. Disgusting. We've had a couple get in the room and start to get frisky instead of playing the game. Had one who was super drunk and just started to piss in the corner of one room. Another lady who had been drinking who decided to stay in the room and puke everywhere, and then put props over the top of piles of puke instead of leaving the room to go to the toilet. And many others. I feel kinda bad about the time our group unscrewed half the pictures on the wall using a paperclip, since none of us had the sense to think that maybe the pictures being screwed down was a sign we weren't supposed to look behind them. Edit, to elaborate, we managed to crack the combination lock to a drawer, which had a jar of paper clips in it, to which our reaction was do we have to pick a lock, at first, and then hey, I think these fit perfectly into the screws, but on the walls. Turns out, the actual purpose of the paper clips was to make a chain, to dangle into a tube, to pick up a key. Can't remember if we had a magnet or a hook to help, which we discovered after looking behind the one picture in the room not screwed down and finding the code to the combination lock on the drawer below the first one. Not terribly ridiculous, but me and the husband loved them and wanted to share our love of them with our family. When we got out of the escape room, the super amazing nuclear explosion room in Chattanooga, Tennessee, the room operator was cracking up laughing. I guess at one point, in order to get keys or clues, my overenthusiastic husband had picked up my 8-year-old nephew by the ankles upside down, and was shoving him in barrels. I had no idea he was doing this, but the operator was dying. My dad owns an escape room in a small town in Norway, and the weirdest thing someone has done is probably trying to punch the camera. The guy was like 150 centimeters tall and couldn't reach it. After trying three times to punch it, he gave up. Oh my god, my time has come. People do dumb shit in escape rooms constantly, but that's the whole point, and it's usually in good fun. The best part of my old escape room job was that it was literally right next door to a brothel. People would frequently come to our door not realizing that they were one door over from where they wanted to be and ask, "Hey, how much?" Me, in my customer service voice, "Well, it depends on how many people you bring. It's $40 each if you're a group of two, and goes down to $32 each if you're a group of eight." Usually we recommend groups of 4 to 6 people. That seems to be the sweet spot. Their looks of horror will make me laugh forever. I once had a group of drunk guys go in, and they ran through their allotted hints pretty quickly. They asked for another hint, and we said over the speakers that they were out of hints. One of the guys threatened to start taking off his clothes until we gave another hint. I interviewed for a job at an escape room. They told me that one of their standard instructions you must tell every group is to not stick things in electrical outlets because too many people did it. Finally, a question I can answer. Most of the time people are just plain stupid. Which can be fun and frustrating depending on how the people react to realizing it. It's very annoying when the people are cocky beforehand and then don't manage anything without a hint and somehow blame us for messing up. There's also been instances of people throwing up or trying to use the prop toilet inside of one of the backquote prison cells, but I think my favorite absurd thing was the one proposal I had while I worked at an escape game. You might think, well, isn't that romantic? And I thought so too, until I found out that escape rooms aren't just something they both love that makes the proposal unique. It was the first room ever. Never played an escape game ever. Weird choice of scenery to propose. Even weirder when you consider that they took two friends with them. But it doesn't end there. They barely managed to get out, and the ring was hidden in the very last queue, so if they hadn't managed, shit would have become very awkward. It did anyway, because when he proposed, neither of their friends really reacted to it, just stood there blankly. Which was made even worse by the fact that the guy was supposed to film the whole thing, which he didn't, and the other girl didn't even know he was proposing, so the surprise at least should have coerced a smile out of her. Nothing. The proposal speech was also delivered with as much passion as a paper bag, and as it turned out, the dude told everyone at the reception that he didn't really want to marry her, at least not for the time being, but she got pregnant, so now it kind of pushed him into it. She said yes, but holy shit, all of us watching were hoping she wouldn't. Now imagine proposing, or even worse, being proposed to in an escape room, knowing you are being watched and listened to through cameras. What an absurd choice to make. There was an escape room by me that had a terrorist themed room. You get kidnapped and locked in a room with a bomb on the door. To up the realism, your host was dressed to fit the role of kidnapper and would come over the radio for hints in persona. Eventually the cops would start coming over the radio to guide you out of the room. Anyway, someone walking by the escape room saw people getting kidnapped and called the actual police. The police came by, and the escape room workers explained that the actual police wanted to confirm with the people in the room. They knocked on the door and said, "Salt Lake City Police, open up," and the group responded, "We can't because there's a bomb strapped to the door." Luckily it ended well with everyone laughing afterwards. News summary: https://www.ksl.com/article/36692107/slc escape room draws police response after confused passerby calls 911. Not an escape room worker, not absurd, but funny. I was at a heist-themed escape room over Christmas, which featured a bit where you have to maneuver past lasers and get a diamond. If you tripped the laser, the display case would close, and you needed to go back to the start of the room to reset everything. After we finished the room, we were told about a group of four elderly women who just walked through the lasers and had one of the group stay at the beginning, resetting the trip. Absolute geniuses. I can just imagine it. The cackling as they break the system. At an escape room near me, they had a group of lads on a stag do. These guys got very drunk, and during the escape room, thought they could escape via the sewers. They managed to rip out the manhole cover, which was bolted down into concrete. This cover is now permanently broken as it's too expensive to fix, they said. Advised us to not escape via the sewers. Not an escape room worker, but second time I went to one, the owner told me that once a group decided to smash all the locks because they found the hammer on which a clue is written. They had to replace all locks, and it is now a toy hammer. I'd like to say those people were morons, but when we found it, the same idea was discussed in our group. I went to one where there were three identical rooms which teams competed in at the same time. If you finished, you then got to watch and listen to the other teams. Our team did pretty well, and we got to watch the other two teams try to complete it. Anyway, there was this one lock which was a number combination, and you solved it by finding some sheet music in a book with 5 notes on it which corresponded to numbers. The piece was entitled The Key or something similar, so you knew you needed it for the lock. Anyway, this other team, instead of converting to numbers and putting in the combination, chanted this 5-note tune at the lock. When it did not work, they tried again, then again, then someone else tried. This went on for 10 minutes and got louder and louder. Eventually the game master stepped in and told them it was not going to work. Apparently they were the only team ever to do that. First thing I had to learn working at an escape room: everything, yes everything, in the room was going to be dismantled, pulled on, or messed with in some way. Have a screwdriver in the room? Maybe there's a clue in the light switch cover. Black light. Must have to take it completely apart. TV for clues? Must have to unplug / change inputs. And anything not nailed down is bound to be broken. Mate worked at an escape room, and he told me that some guys tried to smash a hole in the wall to get out because it was an Alcatraz themed room. A kid I knew from school, his family owns an escape room business. The most things that happen is people trying to take things when it's clearly nailed down or nailed to the wall. Then he said that a little kid pissed in a bottle. Escape room enthusiast here. We spent far more time than I care to admit trying to figure out what the hell the numbers written in Sharpie on the underside of the rug in the middle of the room meant. Turns out they were an inventory number from the thrift store the designer bought the thing from, and nobody else had ever noticed them before. We still won, but that wasted a lot of our time. One guy pissed on the wall, thinking the plaster was snow. Pulled the air vent covers off the walls / floor. Had to add in an official disclaimer in the rules spiel I did before they went in the room: no clues in the air vents. Customers were stupid a lot, but it was a pretty sweet gig overall. Obligatory, not a worker, just done a lot of escape rooms and chatted with the staff. These are the dumbest people I've been told about. 1. One of the rooms is based on Jumanji and has a waterfall with real water in it. Enough people have tried to drink the water that they had to tell people not to in their opening spiel. 2. One of the rooms has a bunch of museum-style display cases with glass covering the top with different puzzles inside. One of has sand in it and small holes in the top. Someone tried to tip the display case over and get the sand out so they could read the hidden message. When the game master told them to stop doing that, she stopped momentarily and then tried again 2 minutes later. The game master told her if she did it again she'd be kicked out, and the woman said, just making sure you're paying attention. 3. People constantly try to pull up floorboards or tear down wallpaper in the horror themed room, even after they are told there's nothing hidden there and warned not to do it or they'll get charged for the damage. Not a worker, but was with a group of people, and one of them became so overwhelmed that almost immediately after walking in, they spun around and walked right back out again. Lifted up all the tiles on the ceiling. I had to wonder exactly what clue brought them to that conclusion. Nothing said up, ceiling, above. Yet every single tiles was down, and, to their credit, piled in a corner. One time, a group was trying to figure out the code to a locked compartment. So this huge guy in the group decided this was a waste of time and tried to rip off the compartment door with his bare hands. He was almost successful, but we stopped him before he could do further damage to the door. He didn't understand what was wrong. Another one happened where a group were handcuffed and they couldn't find the key. The game master was trying to give them clues to find the key, but they still couldn't find it. So one group member thought it would be best to use his leg. There was a table in the room with some items on it. He proceeded to knock over all the items with one kick. That group didn't win. I was a player, and I was in a large cage. Through the bars I had to open a heavy lock. The cage was dimly lit with lead bars on the floor. I got the lock open, but due to it being heavy and me having to handle it through the bars, I dropped it on the lead bar. At first I thought the light turning off was part of the room. Turns out I broke the lead bar. In the Netherlands there is this prison escape room, where everyone is a prisoner and you have to escape prison. It is done in an actual ancient prison. There are about 300 participants and 85 actors, mostly prison guards and some prisoners. They have over 15 storylines which you can follow, and there are other inmates, actors, which will lead those storylines, and send you one quests. Coming back to the question, at the beginning they warned everyone that no physical contact is allowed, because during the first time people would actually threat each other to get money and guards have been attacked. Also they had to warn people that you weren't supposed to try climbing the 50 feet high prison wall. One of them believed the clue was inside them. My buddy guessed a locks combo which gave us the final clue, but we had not found the other ones. We ending up solving the room backwards. When the room administrator came in, she had nothing else to say but what the fuck did you guys do? My friends and I did an escape room a couple years ago. We have to count the number of candlesticks on the carpet pattern or something like that. Instead of just counting them normally, my friend got on his hands and knees on the carpets and went around counting them. When we finally escaped, the guy told us that he had never seen someone do that before and thought it was hilarious.